Assalamualaikum. I'm here with Saira, who I have been wanting to interview for a long time. Hello, Saira. How are you?
How are you?
Good, good. And Saira has been traveling all over the country for Sinfe Ahan. And when Karachi came, I decided to catch her before she went off again and
yeah.
out tour. So Sinfe Ahan, I wanted to ask you, are you about to go on that long Abbottabad spell?
Yes, we are.
You are?
Yes.
And will you be training as a cadet and all the different procedures that are part
Bilkul,
of
Bilkul. We already did a bit of film Gujranwala and we were shooting with actual captains, you know, who were also a part of it. So it was really interesting. And ab hum log jayenge PMA, and that's where we have a long spell, all of us. And it's a very interesting script, the things we have to do in it. So I'm really excited and looking forward to it.
Acha, but have you worked with any of these actors before?
No,
the main
actually.
Actors you have
no,
tried?
I haven't worked with Cobra, I haven't worked with Sajjal, I haven't worked with Yumna, and I haven't worked with Ransha.
None of them. So is it kind of difficult? It's a big ensemble cast.
Yes.
And different genres of actresses, Jessica Sajjal is much more seasoned, right? Kubra is relatively newer, right? Ramsha is newer. You are somewhere in the middle. You've been around, but you've been going on and off, taking a break when you had your child and all that. So is it difficult?
I never took a break.
You never took a break, but you were picky.
I've been selective about my work. So I never took a break. Like I'll be honest, I think when I had Noore, I had her in July, about like 7 years ago. And October I was working.
Achha, but jo tumhe drama offer hote the, I mean, I remember your drama.
On the drama front, I would say that I haven't selected a drama that I would say has, you know, kind of people have watched or whatever. But that's also because mujhe aisa kuch acha nahi laga, aisa kuch samajh mein nahi aaya that I wanted to be a part of.
Aur phir kabhi ye nahi hota jaise bahut se artists mujhse kehte hain ki hame we need to keep stay in the spotlight in order to be relevant.
Yes.
And by being relevant, it just doesn't mean ke fans are talking about them. It means brands are coming to them. They're getting endorsements. They're becoming showstoppers at bridal fashion weeks and all.
Yes.
Right. So isn't there that pressure that you need to be in the spotlight to stay relevant?
No, I feel what's meant for you is meant for you. It'll come your way anyway.
Okay, good. That's a very healthy way of.
Yeah.
And I know you've been talking about that even before you started filming.
Yes.
That's you. You're very, you look at it in a very healthy,
positive
way.
Yeah, because I feel like the second you start running after things, it just puts you in a state of constantly chasing something. And if you just understand that whatever is meant to you is going to come your way anyway, as long as you give it your best. And you know, so for me, it's like as an actor, if somebody sees me in a role and wants me, they will approach me.
Okay.
So I'm not worried about, I don't worry like that.
Okay, so Sinfe Ahan, you are excited about though, right? It's again a different role.
Yes.
Hai na?
Yes.
And can we know a little more about it, or is it top secret right now?
Well, what would you like to know?
Who's the male lead opposite you? That's the big secret.
Well,
or are there no male leads? Is it more about special appearances?
There are many special appearances.
Okay.
That's what I can say to you.
Okay.
The drama has many special appearances, and I think that's what makes this drama so special, because you'll see your favorite actors in so many characters here and there, everywhere. And all those characters, by the way, are just as important. Because, and I think, I can't say it right now, but when the drama comes out, you'll understand that everybody has their own graph. So even who's come for a special appearance actually has a graph. And
it's
actually
a well-planned story.
Yes,
it's a story that makes sense rather than a jumbled up mess.
So I think around the same time, you know, it happens in your life that you start to get a lot of things in one time. And then you have to be like, which one do I want to do? Right? So this was, the Sinfe Ahan came at the same time, and for some reason it just, the story really caught my attention from the other things that I was also reading. And then, you know, there were other things that I really wanted to do again. But because of how I have to manage things for myself, I was like, okay.
Manage things, you mean with your daughter?
Yes.
Okay.
Because that's, for me, that's like
top priority?
Yeah. Yeah, for sure.
Okay.
It's like I've lived my life, and this one.
You're done?
No, I don't think you're done. I won't say I've lived my life. I'd say that I have to make sure that I also manage her in a very healthy way. You know, where I'm not leaving her behind. Where
for
she's
ages and ages.
Yes,
huh?
And you know where she's growing into things in a very healthy way as well. So, but Sin Fiang caught my attention because it was a story about, you know, it's a story about five girls from different backgrounds who kind of actually go into the army. And yeah, so I was just like, that's something we've never done. And when I read it, it's written so beautifully that I was like, you know, it's written well. It's definitely inspirational.
Yeah, also, right?
Yeah,
for girls, for young girls watching it.
Yeah.
And you know how massive the audience is for dramas, right? So, kahan tha ke way of thinking trickle down karte. It's
bilkul,
very important.
Bilkul. And mere liye, I think ye bahut important tha ki is drama ka moral of the story kya hai. You know, or is drama ka kya kehte hain? What message is it giving? And it's a beautiful message that it's giving to people, you know. It's literally...
I hope there's a sad ending. Army dramas I'm always scared of.
Because
somebody
dies.
That's just my personal problem with dramas about soldiers or movies even.
True.
Somebody dies.
That's true.
But you can't say anything.
Yeah. So I'm going to leave that to for people to just...
Think about it. As the drama.
Yeah.
Then everybody worries about that also. You see that on Twitter. Oh, is he gonna die?
I know, because they get so attached to these characters that they like, right? So for me, I think Sin Fiang was... I was just like, this is something I definitely want to be a part of. Yes.
And Nuri is going to be traveling with you while you're in Ahmedabad. Does she get bored? I'm just, you know, it's
sometimes,
because
sometimes,
beyond the glamour. It's a long day of shooting.
Yes. But
so,
she's still on her clock. Which is, her clock is, she wakes up by like 8.
She
right?
go to school. Online.
Yeah. And then do whatever she wants in the day. And then by 8:30 she's back to sleep.
Okay, so she won't have to hang about the set for too long, right?
Yeah.
She has things to do. Okay, cool.
And she was with me in Gujranwala and she got along so well with all of the other girls, Ramsha, Yumna, Cobra, Sajjal, everyone on set, all the girls. She keeps herself very busy. While I'm giving a shot, she's keeping herself busy with others. So it works out.
It might, if she's so comfortable on the set, she might eventually decide that she likes it a lot. And
whatever she wants.
You wouldn't mind.
No, whatever she wants.
No, jab Noore ki baat hoti, I sometimes wonder because you and her, you know, her father are famous people, you know, and you are also in the midst of controversies every now and then, whether you like it or not, Saira. So, does it worry you that these, as your daughter gets older, that these controversies may get to her, you know, eventually? Kids are on social media, they do get to read what others are saying.
Of course.
They do also realize that there are trolls out there who can be very cruel. So, does it worry you when these controversies come in connection to you or her father, and that it could affect her? Do you worry?
I think a parent's job is to worry. That's what a parent does.
All parents worry, regardless.
It would be about everything, right? And I'm one of those parents that I am worrying about the tiniest and smallest thing, ki how is this going to affect her and how is that going to affect her. So I do worry. But I think how I kind of manage to deal with that kind of stress is, I'm responsible for my actions,
right?
And I can do the best I can for her and for myself, and meanwhile I can just prepare her for what it can be like out there, right?
So you'll talk to her. You'll have a bond with her.
I do have a bond with her.
Yeah.
We're actually very close and we have very honest conversations about things. Yes. And she's quite mature, so it helps. But I don't keep anything from her in a way where I don't sugar. I personally believe that when you are bringing up children, you have to kind of tell them, you have to prepare them for what's out there. But also let them know that you're safe and secure if you've got a good compass within yourself. Well, for me, what's really important is the feedback that I get on my acting.
Huh.
That's important to me.
Huh. But that can be positive or negative.
And that's fine.
That's fine.
Yeah.
Okay.
You can have, like, anyone can have their opinion.
Hmm.
It doesn't, I'd like to read and see, because I would like, because then I take it as, okay, does this resonate with me? Is this true? Yeah, I think this person's safe. So then I look at it from that.
Mm.
Then I judge my own project from that angle as well.
Mm.
From
mm.
that lens
mm.
as well.
Mm.
And I'm like, maybe I could have done this better.
Yeah, yeah.
So I take it as healthy criticism. If it's not healthy, then I don't pay attention to it.
You generally tend to know when it's just a vicious attack or
yeah.
when it's actually constructive.
Exactly.
And then you can tell.
Yes.
Okay.
For sure.
You live your life your
yes.
way. You do things that you like. You don't go crazy on social media just in order to trend. That's
mm.
something that's always been consistent about you. Kabhi, even when you trend, you do. It's not because you are saying anything. You're just trending. So, you know, why do you think Pakistan loves you so much? Because I see all this love being showered at you
yeah.
by people who don't even know you.
Yeah.
Wo aise baat kar rahe hote jaise Saira unki best friend. What is this secret formula that makes Pakistan love you so much?
I do wonder sometimes myself, and I come to the conclusion that, like I think I've said this many times since I've come, I think God has been extremely kind to me.
Mm.
And if, and it's His way of kind of telling you that you are loved. You know, He is going to put love
huh.
in people's
huh.
hearts for you.
Huh.
It's not just going to erupt out of nowhere. You know,
okay.
So I feel it's, I look at it like that.
Okay.
Yeah, I look at it like...
So this, it's just love because God wants you to be loved?
I guess.
There's no secret formula to
No, I mean, I haven't done anything to... So I consider it as a blessing. I consider
huh.
it as God's blessing on me. Because then there are people who struggle with the kind of hate that they also receive and the kind of, you know... and it impacts a lot of people, you know.
Huh.
So what I do is I maintain a healthy distance in order for it to not impact me in that way. But meanwhile, if I get lots of love in return, then all I can say is
amazing. Yeah.
Thank you, Allah.
I think you're also well loved because our audience loves young moms.
Hmm.
Who are devoted to their children, and you, regardless of whether they're actually devoted or not,
yeah.
the audience you are not saying, but they assume that oh, you know, she's a mother, she oh, choti si beti hai, beti bhi pyari si hoti, uski kuch tasveere to aati. I think it does have some part of it is due to the fact that you're a young mom.
I think it's also because being a public figure kind of also puts your journey out there
hmm.
for people to see.
Hmm.
And I think seeing that journey, you know, if something of that journey resonates with them or something brings warmth to their hearts,
hmm.
then they automatically develop a fondness for that person.
Tell me, on some cast, people always have favorites, right? A character, sabka favorite ho jata hai. और ये हर मूवी हर फिल्म में होता है हर ड्रामे में होता है यू आर नाउ अबाउट टू बी सीन इन अ ह्यूज एनसेंबल कास्ट ऑफ अ ड्रामा दैट इज ऑलरेडी हाइप्ड अप अभी शूटिंग शुरू हुई है पीपल आर क्यूरियस दे आर आस्किंग अबाउट इट इट्स जस्ट द होल कॉम्बो यू नो नदीम बेग सना शाहनवाज यू गाइस ऑल ऑफ यू द कास्ट आई एम वरीड अबाउट दैट कि पीपल आर गोना हैव फेवरेट्स व्हाट इफ योर कैरेक्टर इजंट द फेवरेट डज दैट एवर कम टू योर माइंड
No. And I'll tell you why. I've done many ensemble cast based things. My first drama
you
ever.
Have. With major stars.
Yes.
Bilkul.
And I look at it as teamwork.
Hmm.
I look at it as being part of this amazing cast.
Hmm.
Right? And I also look at the positives. Everything is not on your shoulders then.
Hmm.
That's a factor to consider,
huh,
right?
True.
Everything is not riding on
if
your
they
shoulders.
They love it, they love all of you. If they hate it, they won't just hate you.
You know.
They'll hate others also.
If they don't like the project, then they don't like the project. But between that, I think for the audience, it is such a treat to have a project where they have all their, like, they have such big actors
together.
You know, together, because when you have, like, when you have a number of actors come together to kind of, you know, which is why films are so fun to watch, because you have a number of actors, good actors, you know, come together to bring this one thing to life.
Right.
And I think uska impact alag hota hai. Dusri baat, I also feel like I've really been wanting to work with Nadeem Beg for a very long time.
Really?
Even though I've worked with him once
long
before,
time.
Long time ago on a telefilm, but I really wanted to do something with him. So for me, I'm like, I'm getting to work with Nadeem Beg, you know, and I'm getting to work in a project which is going to be, it's a fully star-studded project, you know, and everyone is responsible for their characters. And to be honest, like, I've read the entire script, so everyone's character is...
You have the whole script.
Yeah.
That is also a rarity, right?
Yeah.
You have the whole script.
Yeah.
Usually you guys get half the script, right?
Yeah. But I think if you ask for it, you'll get it. It's...
No, kabhi kabhi script puri likhi nahi.
Haan. Lekin jahan, lekin jo maine sara padha, usme every character is so beautifully written, and you know, they
well
have
developed,
well developed characters. So if it's not about ke ek hi ke, I for me it's like there's so much that I'm getting from it already, that once it goes on air, whether people like this character or that character, it's, it doesn't upset me.
That's it. Thank you so much, Saira. This has been great.
Thank
good luck
you. Thank
for
you
your
for
shooting schedule in Ahmedabad. And
thank you.
I look forward to another long interview once in Fayaz.
Inshallah.
Yeah.
Inshallah. For sure.
Thanks.